Saginaw Valley State University football can be traced back to May 2nd of 1994. That's the day the offensive coordinator from perennial Division II power, Pittsburgh State of Kansas, interviewed for the vacancy created when former Cardinal coach George Eiler stepped down. The next day, nearly 2 months after spring practice, the Cardinals had their man. The Jerry Robert Kill era was underway at SVSU, and it would get off to a running start.
Open up, get first down, get two.
Challenges were numerous, but time was short. Coach Kill and his staff needed to evaluate personnel, install the new gear option attack and new defensive schemes, and to find a quarterback to run the offense, with the opener at Northern Michigan less than a month away. Sophomore Gabe Williams picked up the intricate footwork the quickest, and he would get the starting nod on a sunny September Saturday afternoon against the Wildcats.
Decision to start the new era of football at Saginaw Valley State University. The game showed the Cardinals that their veer option offense still needed some work as they gained just 167 yards in total offense. Now 0-1 on the season, the Cardinals' next game was a trip to Detroit to take on the Tartars of Wayne State.
You know, I don't like losing. I've never lost very much in my whole lifetime, but it's all part of it. I know it's going to take time. I think our kids realize that. And we're going to keep plugging away and keep doing what we believe in. Eventually, we'll get over the hump.
Well, getting their first win in Detroit would be no easy task, especially since the Tartars feature Joe Goff, one of the top running backs in the MIFC. And not only that, but quarterback Gabe Williams turned an ankle in the Northern Michigan game, and he would be replaced by junior backup Robert Reeves. Reeves would hit Chucky Davis with a 35-yard touchdown strike with 1:17 to play. An extra point probably ends the game on a tie, but the decision is made to go for the two and the victory. The call is option left, and Robert Reeves sneaks it in the end zone for the score. The two-point conversion makes it 22-21. The Cardinals have their first win, and it's on the road. They improve over last week with 333 yards in total offense. Delshawn Littlejohn rushes for over 100 yards. And now at 1-1, the Cardinals with a full head of steam as they get ready for Northwood and the annual Axe Bowl.
unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard. You gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool. You gotta be calm. You gotta stay together. All I know, love will save the day. Herald what your mother said. Read the books your father read.
St. Joe's 13-12. A rainy day helps the Cardinal defense force four turnovers. Now with a 3-2 record, the Cardinals get ready for one of their biggest tests of the year, hosting one of the top teams in the LIFC, the Ashland Eagles. If the Cardinals were intimidated by Ashland, they certainly didn't show it, jumping on them for 21 first quarter points.
Thank you.
only up the Cardinals' record to 4-2 going to Indianapolis, he also announced that perhaps the Cardinals had arrived a little earlier than expected.
Listen, they call Grand Valley, Paris, and Ashland the big three in our league. And after we beat these guys, we feel like we beat one of the upper echelon teams.
We talked about stepping it up, talked about leaving it on the field, and doing what we had to do to get a W.
SBSU's next game was at the University of Indianapolis. The Greyhounds were struggling, and the Cardinals went there knowing that they were the better team. Problem was, the Greyhounds would make them prove it.
I don't care what you say, just take my word that we're okay.
Touchdown performance helped prove the Cardinals could win the games they were supposed to, even on the road. SBSU's defense gave up just 56 yards rushing in the 42-21 victory, raising their record to an impressive 5-2. Another team that Saginaw Valley was expected to beat, the St. Francis Fighting Saints, were next. And with like most MIFC games, the win wouldn't necessarily come easy. Second quarter points scored by the Cardinals turned out to be enough for a 10-point triumph over St. Francis. SBSU was now 6-2, heading into their final two games of the year. which just happened to be against the nationally ranked teams in the MIFC, Grand Valley, and Ferris State. Rain greeted the Cardinals again on the road in Allendale, as this year's quickly improving squad set out to show that they could play with anybody. Two-time defending league champion. A record 4,000 people would turn out for this one, and they would be treated to a real tug-of-war. Saginaw Valley had lost to the MIFC's two perennial powers by a total of 9 points. And while these games brought their share of pain, they also offered plenty of promise.
It's definitely a tough loss, both losses, Ferris and Grand Valley, and the two previous losses, but everybody said we wouldn't do anything this season. I think we proved a lot of people wrong.
I don't think I've ever in my entire life seen a group of young men give more to the coaching staff than these people did this today and all season long. Our kids, my hat's off to them. They've done a great job, and I couldn't be prouder of them.
Today, today's heartbreaking. It's a wrenching loss. That, you have every angle to win the game, you just don't finish it off. But, to look ahead and look to the future of our program, those kids are there, and they're going to do anything. They're going to do anything they can to help us win championships here.
A disappointing ending, perhaps. A disappointing season? No way. The Cardinals finished with a 6-4 record. That's good for fourth place in the LIFC, tying the school's best ever performance. A total of 32 team and individual school and conference records were tied or broken by this team. The Cardinals set a season attendance record as over 16,000 fans turned out to cheer them on. And there was plenty of media attention, too, including a 30-minute preseason television show, a weekly coaches show on radio, and each and every one of the Cardinal games was broadcast live on the radio. And four players were even invited to play in postseason bowl games. All in all, not a bad beginning. So that's a brief look at the 1994 Cardinal season. What lies ahead in 1995? Well, that will at least partially be determined now during the offseason while snow covers Randall Woods Field. That's because although the 1994 team gave this program a great beginning, it's up to the returning players to decide its future.